Hi, my name is Robin M. Saltness. I'm a product marketing engineer here at Nordic Semiconductor. Today, I would like to tell you a little bit more about this, the nRF5340 development kit. This replaces the nRF5340 preview development kit and makes all the features of the nRF5340 SoC available to the users. Our team of skilled engineers has worked hard on getting this final version ready for release. And we here in Nordic Semiconductor are so excited to let you know all about it. The star of this show is the nRF5340 system on chip. This is the first wireless SoC in the world that features two separate ARM Cortex M33 processors. This makes it a great choice for compute-heavy tasks where a continuous network connection is also required. The application processor is optimized to run at a clock frequency of 128 MHz to ensure the best possible performance for your application, while the networking processor runs at a lower 64 MHz frequency for better efficiency and lower power consumption. Together, these two cores deliver a stable connection and great computing capabilities for any project at a very low power cost. The application processor has 512 KB of RAM and a full megabyte of flash memory. In addition to this, it also connects to the onboard external storage via the QSPI interface, located just south of the SoC itself. So there's plenty of space for your application and their data to be stored in. The chip also supports communication over high-speed SPI and UART. The network processor features 64 kilobytes of RAM and 256 kilobytes of flash memory. It supports common wireless protocols, including Bluetooth Low Energy with direction finding in both the angle of arrival and the angle of departure roles. Bluetooth Long Range, Bluetooth Mesh, and 2 megabits per second bandwidth transfers are also supported. In addition to this, Thread, Zigbee, NFC, ANT, 802.15.4, and proprietary 2.4 GHz protocols are also supported. The nRF5340 is also a very secure chip. It incorporates ARM CryptoCell 312 hardware-accelerated cryptography, ARM TrustZone technology with root of trust, trusted execution, and secure key storage. This allows for the complete separation of your secure and non-secure flash for the highest level of security. In combination with the nRF Connect SDK, our software development platform that integrates the Zephyr Artos real-time operating system, a Bluetooth LE protocol stack, application examples, and hardware drivers, it makes for the perfect platform for developing new products and wireless applications. With its range from -40 to +105 degrees Celsius operating temperature, it is ideal for industrial lighting applications, but also advanced wearables and IoT devices. But let's get back to the board. The white lines forming a square around the SoC and some of its surrounding components indicates all the components needed to power and run the chip on its own. So as you can see, there's not much needed to get this chip fully operational. On the right-hand edge of the board, you find the integrated PCB antenna and the SWF RF port for taking direct RF measurements from the chip. On the top and bottom right-hand corners of the PCB, you will find respectively four user programmable LEDs and four user programmable push buttons. These allow for a simple user interface for your applications in the early stages of your development process. Right next to the push buttons, you find the NFC antenna connector. This allows for near-field communication by attaching the NFC antenna included with your kit. In this area, you also find the board's reset button. The onboard Sega J-Link programmer and debugger, located a bit to the left on the board, allows you to program and debug your applications onto the nRF5340 SoC directly via the USB port, with no separate programmer needed. This reduces the cost of the initial investment needed to get started developing. The board has two USB micro type B ports. The one on the left-hand side of the board is for programming the chip via the onboard Sega J-Link. The one on the top of the board is for directly communicating with the nRF5340 SoC, allowing for direct access to the chip's internal USB interface. For powering the system, you could either use the programmer USB port, the external power supply connector, or the LiPo battery connector, found here just above the power switch. The device accepts a wide span of input voltages from 1.7 to 5 volts. The board also has a coin cell battery holder right on the opposite side of the PCB. you may switch between different power sources using the NRF power source switch on the board. Measuring the current consumption is made easy by the two current measurement headers just above the USB port, allowing for directly monitoring your system's power draw. Even though there is an onboard Segger J-Link programmer and debugger, the board also features a separate debug in port for the use of an external programmer. In addition, the onboard programmer could be used to program other chips using the debug out port, located in the top left-hand corner. Throughout the board, you will find vast amounts of pin headers and through-hole solder pads, allowing you to easily access all of the general purpose inputs and outputs and other analog and digital interfaces of the DK and the SoC itself. So as you can see, the nRF5340 development kit is a powerful and versatile tool for building your wireless applications in a friendly developing environment. We here in Nordic Semiconductor are super excited to see all the new use cases you will find for it. Visit nordicsemi.com for more information about our products and get in touch with our technical support team through devzone.nordicsemi.com. Have a nice day.